We look at the wealthiest people in America today, Warren Buffett, Michael Dell, of course, Bill Gates, Paul Allen, and the Walton family, all first-generation multi-billionaires. And the wonderful thing is if you do what other successful people do, you eventually get the same result that they do.
There are many ways to get the things that we want for ourselves in our lives, but basically, it all begins with how we choose to think.
If you really want to get lasting change, real results that stick around, what do you got to do? If you want lasting change, you've got to give up this idea of trying something. You got to decide you're going to commit to mastery. Most people dabble. They talk about, well, I'd like to change my body, I'd like to change, make my relationship better, I'd like to have more passion there, but they don't know what to do, and even if they did, they don't have enough detail to be able to follow through.
If we want to achieve another result that we've never achieved before, then we have to become somebody different. We have to upgrade our skills, we have to upgrade our behaviors, we have to master our emotions better.
Self-made millionaires have been studied exhaustively, they've been analyzed, they've been interviewed by the hundreds of thousands and millions, and what we know is exactly who they are and what they do and how they think. And the wonderful thing is if you do what other successful people do, you eventually get the same result that they do.
Walt Disney said, if you can dream it, you can do it, which means that you're never given a dream that comes out of your own desire place that isn't something you have the capacity to fulfill. You may have to learn some new skills, you may have to partner up with some people, you may need to learn some, you know, how to access some new resources along the way. But all of that is possible if you'll simply dream the big dream.
Have a mind that is open to everything and attached to nothing. One of the central principles of my life is that no one knows enough to be a pessimist about anything. And that each and every one of us, when we close our mind to what is possible for us or what is possible for humanity, closes off the genius that resides and lives in each and every one of us.
Decide what you want. You can't get from here to there unless you know where here is and there is. So if you're going to decide what you want, go for what you want, not what you think is possible. Most people hone down their dream because they can't see how they can do it. And I'm saying to you, dream as big as you want. In fact, big dreams are exciting. Big dreams attract big people.
I had a teacher named Jim Rohn. He was a personal development speaker. And I remember I was really frustrated and I'd been working my guts out 12, 14 hour days. Nothing was working. And I was pissed off and I was frustrated. And he said, Tony, he said, you're so focused on expecting things to happen so fast. And he said, you know, if you really focus instead on building your skills, your gifts will make room for you. Today, people have no patience. We all want it right now. And people don't only not commit to mastery, they think they have all the answers. They try a few things. If it doesn't work, they run to something else. If you want a great jump in the quality of your life, an extraordinary jump in the quality of your life, you got to set yourself up to win. You got to set yourself up with a process that allows you to consistently grow, consistently enjoy your life, and consistently produce the results that you're really after.
Success is very simple. If you have a clear goal, make a plan to achieve it, and then do something, at least one thing each day, it moves you one step closer to your most important goal.
Progress equals happiness. If you're growing in anything, financially, spiritually, emotionally, in your relationship, in your body, you're going to feel better in your life. That's what we're made for. And I think we're meant to grow so we have something to give. You know, you can't give something you really don't have.
Form good habits and make them your masters.
Most people are interested. They're not committed. And the difference is when you're interested, you do what's convenient and what's easy. When you're committed, you do whatever it takes. When you're interested, you do what's easy and what's convenient for you. But when you're committed, I'm going to get that result, you put everything into it until you get the result.
You got to get going. You got to take action. The disciplines is the miracle process. And here's how to get the miracle of your future going as far as disciplines are concerned. Number one, do what you can. Learning is the beginning of wealth. Learning is the beginning of life change. And don't be lazy in learning. Don't be lazy in picking up the ideas. Don't be lazy in learning from your own experience.
How many times have you had a great idea, didn't do anything about it, and then a year later someone did something about it, made a lot of money, got the promotion, etc.? So when you have the idea, the inspiration to act, it's time. Act. You don't have to know it perfectly.
I am strength, I am wise, and I am passion!
If you decide you're going to do something, do it. You know what, they've done dozens and dozens of studies over the years. They find that there's one major difference between successful people and unsuccessful people. As successful people launch, they start, they get on with it, they just do it. Unsuccessful people get the same ideas and the same information, but they've always got an excuse for not starting.
If you have a big enough reason why you want to achieve something, you'll do whatever it takes. But if your reason isn't big enough, your excuses will be.
And one of the things that we kind of believe and hang on to and live with is this whole idea that all of the things that happened to me in my past are what are keeping me from doing what I'd like to do today. So we hang on to these things and we fill ourselves with blame.
Because life is not so simple and black and white. My mother beat the shit out of me. She loved me. She was freaked out I was gonna leave. I was her source of everything. I blame her for all the beauty in my life. I blame her that I have the woman I have in my life because I cherish my wife because I know what the opposite is. I blame her for the capacity to feel and care. I blame her for my insatiable hunger to end suffering for any human I can. Because I suffered a ton. Get emotionally fit by learning to trade what upsets you, which is your expectations that aren't being met. Trade your expectations for appreciation for what you do have. Your whole life changes in a moment. Because our expectations make us pissed off or frustrated or worried or sad, and we all have them, and I have them too. But when they come up, I just remind myself, look, this is just my mind. I'm more than this mind. I got a heart and soul. What can I appreciate? How can I use this challenge to go to a deeper level? And that's the only way we get free. The only way to have a great life is decide I'm gonna find beauty in anything that happens in my life. I'm sure if you look back on your life, most of us have had experiences where, you know, something horrible happens, something you never want to go through again in your lifetime. But at the same time, you know that 5-10 years later, you look back and go, I would never want to go through it. I would never want anybody I care about to go through that. But I'm glad I did, because it made me so strong to deal with that.
When you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change.
What makes us suffer is our thoughts, right? We're the only creatures on earth that can have thoughts and then make ourselves feel like shit, or have thoughts and make ourselves feel good. And most people don't master their minds. And so their minds go crazy, and we believe our thoughts. We believe that if this doesn't happen, our lives are gonna be so stressed or over, and most of it is just bullshit. The mind is looking for what's wrong. Your heart can change all that. If you decide today, and if this is all I got across in this piece and I actually reached you, is for you to decide that I'm 100% responsible for the experience of my life, and that anything can happen. I am bigger than the moment. I am more than anything can happen to me, and I can find a way to find something beautiful, something helpful, something, you know, enjoyable.
Change your thoughts and you change your world. Change your expectations and you change around what you begin to manifest and see showing up in your life.
I'm not asking you to stop blaming. I'm saying blame elegantly, blame intelligently, blame effectively. Blame at the level of your soul, not the level of your f***ing head.
No more blame. I'm just not going to assign responsibility to other people for where I am, because now I have an opportunity to get rid of it. If I think someone else caused it, then I've got to wait for somebody else to change in order for me to get rid of it, and you might wait forever for that. But if I take responsibility for it, I can do something.
Everyone in the world
has a list of things they think they should do. I should lose weight. I should work out. I should spend more time with my kids. I should work harder. I should make more calls. I should. And then you know what? People don't do their shoulds, and they get mad at themselves and make what I call shit all over themselves. They beat themselves up about it. What changes people is when your should becomes a must. When suddenly the thing you said should happen has to happen. That's when human beings change. It's like if you want to take the island and you're the head of the army, you want to take the island, the most powerful way to take the island is burn the boats. Because if there's no way to go back, it's amazing what happens when it's a must to do something versus a should.
No matter how busy you are, no matter what's on your plate, you absolutely must, if you want to be legendary, you absolutely have to do this. Schedule 60 minutes a day for your learning. It could be listening to audiobooks. It could be the next day listening to a podcast. It might be reading quietly. It might be writing in a journal, because writing in a journal about what you're learning, what you learned from your day, what you're learning from your life, that is learning. But 60 minutes a day, I absolutely challenge you with great love and respect. Wire it into your day, because that ritual will allow you to know more about your field than anyone who's ever done your field in the history of the world.
If you want to change the world, you've got to keep trying new things. You've got to keep pushing. You've got to keep falling down.
When you're starting your day at 4:30 in the morning, whatever, do that. The rest of your day, no matter what happens, is a breeze. You've tackled the hardest part of your day. No matter what goes on, you have the confidence and you have the wherewithal, the tool belt, if you will, to be able to attack. Sometimes it's just showing up and being able to push yourself a little bit more than yesterday. I call it finding your hard. You know, when you find your hard every day, man, life is a lot better. You know, because what happens is you're either the CEO of your life or you're gonna be someone else. You're gonna be life's employee. And every day if you wake up and you don't take control of your day and you don't dominate the day as best you can start to finish, life is gonna own you. You know, if you're waking up with a negative attitude, you have to be able to step back and self-assess, why am I in a bad mood? And you have to work from that minute forward to build that tool in your belt, if you will, to be able to assess it, address it, apply it, if you will, and then move forward. If you can do that, I'll tell you, life gets exponentially easier and easier and easier every day. And before you know it, you're working with greater efficiency, more confidence, more determination, and you set yourself on a path to truly self-generate success. But more importantly, you're happy.
We have the power to strip away from the busyness, to do great work that matters. We have the power to be the most positive people we know. We have the power to shift from making excuses to creating results. You have the power to use today to make a choice to get really fit or to create the financial life that you want.
If you don't like the way your career is or your business is, change it. If you don't like your body, change it. If you don't like your relationship, change you first. Because if you change it, you'll bring you to the next one. Maybe it's time to change it too, but change yourself first. If you want to change anything in your life, you have the choice. So there's no right or wrong. I just want to make you aware in this breakthrough session that everything in our life changes the moment we make a decision. And I mean a real decision. A decision is when you cut off any other possibility and you commit to something with everything you've got and you take action. But the big decisions start with little decisions like, what am I going to focus on? Because whatever you focus on, you're going to feel.
The number one defining factor of whether we become successful or average is whether we have grit. Grit is the ability to stay true to your vision and not dilute it when you get laughed at. Grit is the ability to try an innovation, experience failure, and to say, I'm going to continue and I'm actually going to learn and use that experience to get me closer on my path to the mountaintop.
Is the one thing in life on which we can absolutely count. People who stay young all the years of their lives not only welcome change, but see it for what it really is, new opportunity, new chances for further fulfillment. Attitude is a reflection, a result of a person's will. It is incalculably powerful. It can bring about marvelous results for us, but we need to train it patiently, day by day.
education is inoculation against disruption. And as you know more, you can achieve more.
I like to use one quote that the limitations exist only in our minds, and if you start using imagination, then your possibilities become limitless.
If you're going to be successful in creating the life of your dreams, you have to believe that you are capable of making it happen. You have to believe that you have the right stuff and that you're able to pull it off. Now, whether you call it self-esteem, self-confidence, or self-assurance, it's a deep-seated belief that you have what it takes, the abilities, the inner resources, the talents, and the skills to create your desired results. Now, believing in yourself is simply an attitude. Believing in yourself is a choice. You have to choose to believe that you can do anything you set your mind to, anything at all, because in fact, you can.
People who reach the top in whatever they're doing consistently say that you need to follow your passion. And I think the number one reason why people fail in business, in life, is because they're not doing the thing that they're passionate about. It's because they're making too many decisions with the head and not the heart. Where for every major decision that you make in your life, the big ones, you have to make with your heart and not your head, because your head will lead you down the wrong path. Your head only understands the logical world that currently exists, where your heart can help you create something that does not yet exist. And you have the ability, the skills, the talent, the tenacity to be able to create something that nobody else has ever done before.
Don't stop. Narrow your focus to one idea, one, and make it work. That will give birth to all the others.
Look, I suggested that this driving force is critical to making your dreams come true, providing for your family, to make those goals, that purpose that is unique to you, real, a real reality, not just a concept in your mind. Motivation is literally the desire to do things, and I know you have it in you. That's why you're watching this. That motivation is the difference between waking up before dawn, okay, to go out excited and staying in the workplace for longer than anyone else, and then when you get home at night exhausted, you still can't go to sleep. You're excited. You're motivated. This is that crucial element in setting and attaining goals.
Anything you want is possible.
The number one thing that's going to change your life, the only thing that will change your life, change your business, change your money, change your relationship, is you must raise your standard.
Your life can be too big to allow yourself to play too small.
The only thing that changes our life long term is when we raise our standards. It means that all of us in life have things we want. We don't get what we want, we get what we have to have.
What you're looking for and what you're talking about and what you need is self-discipline. Now, self-discipline, as the very term implies, comes from the self. It comes from you. It comes from when you make a decision to be disciplined. When you make a decision to be better. When you make a decision to do more and to be more.
Well, I think the one thing that discipline definitely does help you with is it helps you get things done. And when you get things done, when you actually do things, you have more success.
Make some choices. With new choices, you're going to get new results. With new results, you're going to get transformation.
When you're no longer willing to tolerate something, that's when your life changes.
Develop the habits. You've got the brain power, you've got the energy, but develop the habits of success.
We know that one of the things about high achievers, they all have goals.
So literally, without goals, you're directionless. You will be used. See, people without goals get used by other people who have them. People that don't have goals work for people who do.
But you know about Michael Phelps? What allowed him to be able to push beyond that moment is his rituals. Go study the guy. Most people who swim have these unbelievable workouts. He does 2 and 3 of those workout sessions a day. All the other swimmers in the beginning thought he was insane. You can overtrain, you can't do that, it's not physically possible. But he had a standard and the rituals to back it up.
If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. There are always going to be ups and downs, but I think it's really how you really, you know, get back on your horse and keep going forward. And I think the biggest thing that I've always said is never give up. And I never have, and nobody ever should. If they want something bad enough, they'll get it. They have to work for it. Yeah, it's not going to be easy. But if you want it bad enough, they'll do whatever it takes to get there.
If you look at great athletes, for example, it's not that they were naturally talented, whether it's a Kobe or a Michael Jordan or a Federer. It was the quality of their rituals.
If you think you can make a difference, it requires commitment.
The pro goes to work, and it doesn't matter if you're sick, doesn't matter if you have kids, it doesn't matter what you're a pro, and you go to work. And that just, it puts it in your head that this is what I do.
If you don't do the work steadily every day, like an athlete going to the gym and practicing, if you don't do the work, if you don't act on the ideas, if you don't integrate them, if you don't show some self-discipline, no idea will work unless you do the work.
Everyone in the world has a list of things they think they should do. I should lose weight. I should work out. I should work harder. I should. And then you know what? What changes people is when your should becomes a must. When suddenly the thing you said should happen has to happen. That's when human beings change.
Unless you take some new action, unless you start thinking some new thoughts, unless you start having some new conversation, unless you have the guts to clean out some of the things that are not working and install some of the new rituals that will work, nothing will change.
The road to success is through commitment and through the strength to drive through that commitment when it gets hard. And it is going to get hard and you're going to want to quit sometimes, but it'll be colored by who you are and more who you want to be.
You want to know what makes us happy? Progress. That's it. I don't care how big your life is compared to other people. Progress is the game, my friends. It's being alive.
There is no single secret of success. There are hundreds of things that you have to do. The most important quality for success is self-discipline. It's self-discipline. You see, most people know that they need to get up earlier, and they need to work harder, and they need to study and become better at what they do. And they need to set goals and manage their time and learn new things. They know this, but they don't have the discipline to do it. So the starting point of success is always self-discipline.
If you're doing something that you're not totally committed to, if you're doing something that you're not totally passionate about, you're compromising yourself every day.
Most of you, are waking up every day looking for pain, dysfunction, drama, unemployment that's stopping you from becoming successful.
When you resolve, this is how it's going to be, that's when you cut off any possibility except the thing you've committed to. It's like the old adage, if you want to take the island, you burn the boats. Because when you burn those boats, there's no going back. You're going to find a way to make things work. And most people, they're stating what they hope will come together. And if it doesn't happen, then they're disappointed, but they're not too disappointed because they're not too vested.
You are the reason you're not winning. You keep messing with negative evil and dysfunctional people and expecting positive results. It's time you get off the pity party, stop complaining about being out of shape when you never go to the gym. You are the reason you look the way you look. You are the reason you're unemployed. You are the reason why your surroundings are so dysfunctional and negative.
When you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful, as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
You got to have a plan. Everybody's got a dream. Everybody's got a goal. What's the plan? And your plan has got to have something I call the C5 complex. Your plan has got to be clear, concise, compelling, consistent, and committed. You've got to have a plan. And when you're trying to do something that you're truly passionate about, there is no plan B.
That most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want a party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep. Some of you love sleep more than you love success. And I'm here to tell you today, if you're going to be successful, you've got to be willing to give up sleep.
Excuses sound best to the people that's making them up. You got every excuse in the world. That's why your shit ain't moving. That's why ain't nothing changed and nothing will change. Because you have convinced yourself that everything is wrong, everything is negative, and nothing will change. And guess what? It won't change. Change your mind and it will change your life. Change, if nothing around you changes, change the things that are around you.
Changing your life is a change in the inner game. The outside world you can't control, but you have absolute control over this one if you learn the dynamics of what shapes you. And identity is one of those simple, clear, fundamental basics that if you start to shift it, everything else will shift in your life as well.
Being a victim. I stopped saying I've got to wait for good things to happen to me, and I said I'm going to grind. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power every single day. I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim. Now let me say this before I move forward, and I can't explain it, but you better feel it. Winners win and losers lose.
And success, by the way, is not some overnight event. It's all these little things. Success is having a vision. Success is making it compelling. Success is really seeing it, feeling it every day with strong enough reasons. Success is feeling the sense that I'm here to grow and I'm here to give something to the world more than just myself.
Don't allow anyone, friend, family, acquaintance, teachers, whoever it is, don't allow anyone to tell you that what you are dreaming for yourself and your family is not possible. It is possible. Because you let your dream get away from you.
If you're not where you want to be, it's because you're not who you need to be right now. And dreaming and hoping is not going change your situation. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with dreaming. We'll talk about that. I'm not talking about, you know, not having a vision. You have a vision, but listen to me. You are where you are because of who you are. And if you're going to get somewhere else, you're going to have to change something.
The doctor said I would never walk. They said I would never run. They said I would never jump, play sports. And here I am, defying the odds. For me, the only true disability in life is a bad attitude.
One of the things that's causing this funk that people are in is that we're living our lives, many of us at least, in these very unfulfilling ways, where you're going to this office with artificial light, and you're doing something you don't want to do all day long, and then you get home and you're tired. We're supposed to be out in the fields. We're supposed to be walking up hills. We're supposed to be looking for animals or gathering vegetables. We're supposed to be doing all these things that our body's designed to do. We're supposed to be in nature.
I've read a couple of places where you said you've had You struggled with depression from time to time.
I was on Prozac for a long time. Yep, I was on Prozac for a long time, and I'm not sure. I mean, it may have helped me out of a jam for a little bit, but people stay on it forever. You know, I had to get off at a certain point because I realized that, you know, everything's just okay. Life is too beautiful.
So when we have situations in our life, most people are defined by those situations emotionally. They brand them, and they no longer want to move forward.
Am I going to sit and cry and be upset and be mad about it? Or I'm going to do something about it? I'm thankful that I'm missing my legs. I'm thankful for that because it allowed me to learn certain things and gain certain tools for me to be the person I am today.
Your adversity is your advantage. And that your past, whether you had a terrible childhood or whether you've suffered from some difficult experiences in life, you should cherish those as your advantage, because that was the training that gave you the muscle development to go do extraordinary things that ordinary people just can't do.
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or anybody.
You're either the CEO of your life or you're gonna be someone else. You're gonna be life's employee. And every day if you wake up and you don't take control of your day and you don't dominate the day as best you can start to finish, life is gonna own you. You know, if you're waking up with a negative attitude, you have to be able to step back and self-assess, why am I in a bad mood? And you have to work from that minute forward to build that tool in your belt, if you will, to be able to assess it, address it, apply it, if you will, and then move forward. If you can do that, I'll tell you, life gets exponentially easier and easier and easier every day.
What you're looking for and what you're talking about and what you need is self-discipline. Now, self-discipline, as the very term implies, comes from the self. It comes from you. It comes from when you make a decision to be disciplined. When you make a decision to be better. When you make a decision to do more and to be more.
How do you create your life? You get hungry for something, don't you? Who has done something in your life that once seemed difficult or impossible, and now it's part of your life? It was once just a vision. It may have seemed impossible at one time. So how did you do it? You started with a concrete vision of what you wanted, and you focused on it continuously, didn't you? Wherever focus goes, energy flows. You envisioned something, you got clear about it, and then you started thinking about all the reasons why you wanted it. You got excited about it. So this is what's next for me now. I want this. You may have dreamed about it, thought about it, talked about it. But when you focus on something continuously, something magical happens. You get insights, don't you? You overhear a conversation, you hear something you wouldn't have heard if you didn't have that outcome or goal that you wanted so badly.
What I say to you now, looking at me now, here, I am a human being. There's no difference between my humanness and your humanness. The only thing is, if you're trying to get there, you cannot stop believing in any way. No matter what anybody says, no matter what anybody tells you, you have to know it beyond knowing it. When something is for you, this is how I knew it was for me. When something's for you, there's a feeling that is deep down inside of you that will not allow you to let it go. It will keep you going when you can't even keep yourself going.
the number one thing that's going to change your life, the only thing that will change your life, change your business, change your money, change your relationship, is you must raise your standard. And what do I mean by standards? Everyone in the world has a list of things they think they should do. What changes people is when your should becomes a must. When suddenly the thing you said should happen has to happen. That's when human beings change.
Make some choices. With new choices, you're going to get new results. With new results, you're going to get transformation.
I was poor because I didn't have anything. I had no money, I had no things, we had no TV, we had no refrigerator, we had nothing as kids. But I was rich because I had a dream.
Start looking into the future of what you would like to accomplish, where you would like to go, the person you would like to be, and see if you can't get a better picture of the finished objective. See yourself there, see yourself in possession of.
As an apprentice plumber, I did a year in that, and it just wasn't for me, you know. My dream is to be world champion, world lightweight champion in the UFC, have more money than I know what to deal with, and have a great life for my kids, my grandkids, everyone in my family, everyone that's come up with me. That's my dream. My dream is to be number one, pretty much. My goal is number one MMA.
So many people think that, like, you have to have a mother or a father in your life. Like, you have to go to a certain school. You have to, and I don't believe that. I believe when you wake up and you're ready to, like, live, at that point, I can help you get from where you are to where you want to be. And that's why I say, you know, some people think, you know, when you look at certain successful people, maybe their father's passed something down or their mother's passed down. It's like, no, it doesn't make a difference if they pass it down or not. Everybody's got to wake up and grind. If you're willing to work like they're willing to work, you can have whatever you want.
The road to success is through commitment and through the strength to drive through that commitment when it gets hard. And it is going to get hard, and you're going to want to quit sometimes, but it'll be colored by who you are and more who you want to be.
Use that mind control to move your life where you want it to be. It's the things I always say: get stronger, faster, smarter, quicker, friendlier, more helpful, more driven. Don't let your mind control you. Control your mind. And once you control your mind, then you can set it free.